Quando un nostro cameraman sale a bordo di un elicottero, il pilota gli
domanda: "When one of our cameramen gets in a helicopter, the pilot asks him how much he weighs and how much his equipment weighs. This is for safety reasons. Now the weight on a boat is not so decisive, but saving a few pounds is always positive."
Se poi si tratta del motore, il peso è ancora più importante.
If we're talking about the engine, the weight is even more important. Yes, because a few pounds more here, near the center of gravity, simply affects the performance. But down there, at the stern, the weight changes the ascent on the hull, as well as the comfort and even the safety. On this inflatable boat, the 620 Easy Life built by Focke, we installed the Suzuki engine, the 100 horsepower. Its exact abbreviation is DF100B. Before trying it and before having a look over Venice, let's see how it was made.
Il costruttore giapponese lo ha lanciato come un...
The Japanese manufacturer has launched it as a champion of lightness. In fact, it delivers 100 horsepower and weighs 157 kilograms, which is 20 kilos less than the heaviest competitor.
L'unità termica è la stessa che equipaggia anche i modelli.
The thermal unit is the same that equips the 70, 80 and 90 horsepower models, and it is equipped with all those technical features that represent the technological level achieved nowadays by Suzuki Marine.
Prima ho parlato dell'importanza del peso laggiù a poppa. È dovuta essenzialmente alla distanza che c'è fra il motore.
I talked about the importance of the weight on the stern. It is essential due to the distance between the engine and the center of gravity of the boat. It is a sort of lever that amplifies the importance of the weight over there, far from the strongest point of the boat.
Suzuki già da qualche tempo per ovviare a questo problema.
Suzuki, for some time, to overcome this problem, has tried to reduce this. Yes, a little, but they have tried, and they have made engines with a transmission system different from other outboards. In practice, they have done in a way so that the engine block, the heaviest part, was a bit more forward, a little closer to the boat's center of gravity. And on a hull so small, the difference can be perceived by a very attentive pilot.
Il sistema di trasmissione di questo motore e di altri modelli Suzuki è diverso.
The transmission system on this boat and of other Suzuki models is different from that of other outboards. In practice, there is a double reduction ratio. It means that the gears, being double, are smaller.
Ora provo a spiegarmi. C'è una riduzione all'uscita.
Now I'll try to explain. There is a reduction in the outboard of the engine, below the grill, and this does not matter much. And then there is another underwater.
Ed è quella più interessante perché siccome
and is the most interesting because here they have succeeded to make the small gears over there in the cone of the torpedo. This engine has a lower hydrodynamic resistance, which means it penetrates the water better, so it is more efficient. It gives more speed and consumes less.
Tutto questo porta un altro vantaggio.
All of this brings another advantage, as there is a double reduction. The propeller turns more than 2.5 times less than the crankshaft.
È come se in auto avessimo sempre una marcia corta e in barca o in gommone.
It is as if in a car we always have a low gear, and in a boat or rubber boat this is necessary because the hull must always push a lot of water to move forward, to glide. And so it is important to have the available torque with gears that allow this type of reduction and that allow a larger propeller to be mounted, which precisely due to its dimension, it slips less in the water and therefore is more efficient. The operating data of the engine is visible on the Suzuki instrumentation, but also on an external display, such as this one of the Simbrad.
Ecco, qua abbiamo tutta una serie di dati dedicati al motore, ma ovviamente il display può essere utilizzato anche nelle sue funzioni.
Here we have a whole series of data dedicated to the engine, but obviously the display can also be used in its more traditional functions, such as for the echo sounder, or to visualize, I don't know, the maps you can connect to camera. You can use it as a traditional tool and additionally, in fact, to have the engine data available digitally.
Il Focky 620 Easy Life è lungo 620 centimetri, è largo 2,54 metri.
The Focky 600 Easy Life is 620 centimeters long, 2.54 meters wide, and weighs just 450 kilograms. It has 5 compartments of air in its tubular and can carry 10 people. It's great to arrive in Venice with your inflatable boat. Well, it's not exactly mine, but for today, yes. The charm of Venice is that it is like a boat. Yes, it is a city on the water, and by boat, we are on the water. And as the Venetians love to have the water under their house, but not in their home, we also love to have water under the boat, but not in the boat. So far we have gone slowly because you have to travel the canals at limited speed, and I could do that thanks to a Suzuki system that allows you to control the minimum speed from 650 to 1200 rpm in steps of 50 rpm. I think this will also be used by those who go fishing to find their perfect speed for their catch. But now I want to speed up. Safety lock is detached, gear is engaged, and hand on the throttle, the other on the rudder.
Ah, perbacco, siamo già impranata ad appena 8 nodi.
Ah, wow, we are already beginning to plane, just 8 knots. Well, if there's one thing you cannot debate when talking about the Focky inflatable boats, it is their ascent. They are made to navigate well at any pace, even when you are going very slowly. It is a prerogative of the manufacturer, Gianpaolo Focky, to not make trendy dinghies that are full of useless tinsel and yacht accessories, but to mind the substance, that they can run fast and that they, in fact, have an ideal angle of incidence. Let's see if this happens at other speeds. Trim all the way down. We go to 3000 rpm. The boat is sitting well in the water, also because the tubes work as they should. They are big at the stern, 60 centimeters in diameter. On the bow, however, they taper to 30 centimeters, a bit for style and a bit for aerodynamics. On this engine, there is a system that saves fuel. When you go at a constant speed, when you do not ask for power and torque to the engine, because you just keep your pace, do not increase it, the electronic control unit slowly slows down the carburation. It leaves unchanged the amount of air that enters the combustion chamber, but reduces the drops of gasoline.
Suzuki ha chiamato tutto questo impianto Lean Burn.
Suzuki has called all this system Lean Burn. But when I insert the cruise control on my car, isn't there a system like that?
Hmm.
3,500 revolutions a minute. Here, the engine data starts to get interesting.
Il consumo è di...
Consumption is 9.4 liters per hour. I think that is quite low in relation to other engines of the same power. And the speed is 18 knots. It's already time to give a bit more trim. This boat is just made to fly. Now I want to measure the noise level. We are at a speed of 25 knots and the sound level meter records
25 knots.
Consider that it is exposed to the wind, so all in all there is not a great noise. The threshold of acoustic comfort of this type of boat is around 85 decibels.
4500 giri minuto.
4,500 revolutions per minute, 14 litres. It is very low consumption.
E se lo traduciamo in miglia per litro, siamo.
And if we translate it into miles per litre, we are at 1.7, 1.8 miles with a litre. This engine is a 1,502 cubic centimeters, a traditional four-cylinder inline engine with four valves per cylinder, a double overhead camshaft, a bit like a car engine.
Adesso lo facciamo cantare un po', eh?
Now let's make it sing a bit, eh? 5,000 RPM. Ah, 6,000 RPM. 35, 36 knots.
Fuori dall'acqua in assetto leggero. Oh, adesso siamo
everything out of the water in lightweight. Oh, oh, now we are at a mile for a liter. Maximum consumption 32 liters per hour.
Allora, pesa poco. È molto efficiente, ha un'ogiva con una
base. So it weighs little. It is very efficient. It has a torpedo cone with a low hydrodynamic resistance. It consumes rather little, but is it reliable?
Dovete sapere che il sistema di distribuzione è stato realizzato non con la solita.
You should know that the distribution system was made not with the usual belt, but with a self-adjusting oil-bathed timing chain. In short, there is no need for maintenance.
A noi piacciono questi motori che ci
and we like these engines that make life more comfortable, more serene, especially because on a boat or inflatable raft, we are having fun, right? No?